Welcome back to Geometry Classroom. Today we'll talk about combinations. We have two objectives. We apply and calculate combinations and solve applications involving combinations. But first, let's define what combination is. Combination is a selection of items in which order is not important. In other words, the order doesn't matter, right? So, just for your information, because we'll not, calculate a combination of n objects taken r at a time by hand, but just for your information, combination of n object taken r at a time would be n factorial over r factorial times n minus r factorial. That's the formula, right? But we don't use this formula. We use calculator that which compute this combination automatically. Yes? Now, as let's say a conclusion, right, of our lessons for now regarding permutations and combinations, to make a separation, a difference, right? A combination is an arrangement of items in which order does not matter, right? While a permutation is an arrangement of items in a particular order, right? So the order matters. That's the difference between permutations and combinations. So when we have problems where the order matters, we use permutations. When we have applications where the order doesn't matter, we use combinations. Now let's have a few examples with combinations, right? In this example, it says find the combination of 22 objects taken 20 at a time, right? Now, to find this combination, again, we use calculator, right? This time, we press menu 5, 3, right? And again, we type the number that is to the left of C. Again, the number that is to the left of C, right, is, the number that is to the left of C is the size of the set and is the largest number, right? The number that is to the right of C is less than the set of the size of the set, right? Is the number of objects selected, right? So let's go back to calculator. So we press 22, comma 20. And then we hit enter. So we get here 231, right? So this is 231. Good. Another example, combination of 17 objects taken 10 at a time, right? Again, we use calculator. We press menu 5, 3. Again, first is 17, comma 10, and then hit enter. Is 19,448. Yes?
Then, next,
combination of 18 objects
taken 11 at a time,
right? Again,
we press menu 5, 3. First, we type 18, comma 11, and then hit end. So, would be 31,824. Good. Another example. There are 20 members in a club. 5 people are selected to go to the state conference. In how many ways can the 5 members be selected? Again, the order doesn't matter, right? So, we have to find the combination of 20 members, because this is the size of the set, right? Taken how 5 at a time, right? Right? So, we find this combination again by pressing menu 5, 3, then 20 first, right? Then comma 5 and press end. Is 15,504. 15,504. Possible ways of choosing 5 members. Another example, how many different ways can a theatrical group select 2 musicals and 3 dramas from 11 musical and 8 dramas? Now, the 3 dramas can be chosen from 8 dramas and 2 musical from 11 musical. Because this selection doesn't matter, the order doesn't matter, right? So, first, we write the combination of 11 musicals taken 2 at a time, right? Because we have to choose 2 musicals out of 11. Then we have to multiply by the combination of 8 dramas taken 3 at a time. Why we multiply these 2 combinations? Because we have 2 different activities. And according to the fundamental counting principles, we have to multiply this number of ways of doing each activity, right? Now, so let's find this product. So we press menu 5, 3, right? So first is 11, comma 2, right? Times, again, menu 5, 3, 8, right? Comma 3. And then we hit enter. Is 3,080. Different ways of choosing this selection. Now, another example, last one. There are 10 seniors, 8 juniors, 5 sophomores, and 3 freshmen on student council. a committee of 6 members is formed. Determine the number of ways to form this committee given the following conditions. The committee is chosen at random, right? In other words, doesn't matter what members are, right? Or where the members come from, right? Because the order doesn't matter, we have to find the combination of what is the set, the size of the set is simple. We add all these number of students, right? We have 10 seniors, 8 juniors, 5 sophomores, and 3 freshmen. So 10 plus 8 is 18, plus 5 is 23, plus 3 is 26, right? Now, we have to choose 26 objects, 6 at a time, because the committee consists of 6 members, right? So we're gonna write here 6. So it's combination of 26 students, 6 taken at a time, right? So we find the combination by pressing menu 5, 3, right? So 26 comma 6, and we press enter. So is a huge number, is 230,230. Good. Now the second a condition is the committee must have 3 seniors, 2 juniors, and 1 sophomore. Now, when we choose seniors, we choose from 10 seniors, 2 juniors from 8 juniors, and 1 sophomore from 5 sophomore. So, because the order doesn't matter, we use combinations. And these combinations must be multiplied, yes, between them. So you're gonna have here combination of 10 seniors taken 3 at a time, right? Because we need 3 seniors times. Then combination of 8 juniors, right? Taken 2 at a time, right? Because we have only 2 juniors, times combination of 5 sophomore taken 1 at a time, right? So all we need to do is to multiply them. Let's find the product. So menu 5, 3, right? Then we say 8 comma 2 times menu 5, 3, 5 comma 1, let's say, yes, times menu 5, 3, and we have 10 comma 3. Yes? And we hit enter. So we have 16,800 possible ways. 16,800 possible choices. Now, another case, the committee must have 4 seniors and 2 juniors. Again, 4 seniors are chosen from 10 seniors and 2 juniors from 8 juniors. So we're gonna have combination of 10 seniors taken 4 at a time times combination of 8 juniors taken 2 at a time, right? Again, we find the product. menu 5, 3, here 10, right, comma 4, times menu 5, 3, and we type 8, comma 2, right, and we hit enter, so it's 5,880. Students, right? Now, the last example, the committee must have at least 4 seniors, right? So this time is a little bit more complicated, because at least 4 seniors means 4 seniors, 5 seniors, or 6 seniors, right? Now, when we have 4 seniors, right, we have to choose 4 seniors out of 10. So, because the order doesn't matter, we have a combination of 10 seniors taken 4 at a time, right? But remember, the committee consists of 6 members, right? So we still need 2 more members. But the other 2 members, right, don't matter, right? Doesn't matter where they come from juniors, sophomores, or freshmen, right? So we have to multiply the combination of the remaining students. The remaining students are juniors, 8 juniors, 5 sophomores, and 3 freshmen. So the size of the set of the remaining students is 16, is 8 plus 5, 13 plus 3 is 16. And now we have to choose two remaining students out of 16, because the order doesn't matter, we use here combination of 16 taken 2 at a time, right? Now, this is the first case. The second case is when we choose 5 seniors. When we choose 5 seniors, right, we choose 5 seniors out of 10, right? So it's a combination of 10 seniors taken 5 at a time, right? Now, but because we choose 5 seniors and the committee should consist of 6 members, right? There is 1 member left. But this member, right, is chosen from the rest of the students remaining, right? And of course, the remaining number of students is the same as we had in the previous case, is 16, right? And we choose 1 out of 16 from this, from 16. So we use combination of 16 taken 1 at a time, right? And the last case, when we have 6 seniors, right? When we have 6 seniors, we choose 6 seniors from 10 seniors. Because the order doesn't matter, we use combination of 10, chosen 6 at a time, right? Now, because the committee consists of 6 members, we don't have any student left, right? So we should multiply this combination by the combination of the remaining students, which is 16, taken 0 at a time, right? Because there is no other, student left for the committee. because all committee consists of six seniors, right? What's next? We have to find each product and then add them. Now, let's find, using calculator, how much would be the whole sum, right? Remember, first time we find this product. So we have menu 5, 3, right? So we have 10, comma 4, times menu 5, 3. 16, comma 2, right? Then plus menu 5, 3, 10, comma 5, times menu 5, 3, 16, comma 1, plus menu 5, 3, 10, comma 6, times menu 5, 3, 16, comma 0. Yes, and you hit enter. So you'll get 29,442. Yes, so 29,442 possible committees having this condition. This is all we have for today. Thank you for watching my video.